Hello and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Today, I'm at the auto dealership, and I'm looking to make a very important decision, choosing my next vehicle. There are so many different features for each vehicle. It can be overwhelming, but you have to think it through. Choosing a car is similar to a common problem that separation scientists face every day. How to select columns that will give them the best chance of separating their sample. They could go with a column that has worked for a different separation in the past, but that may not be the right column for their current separation. Selecting a column may not be as fun as test driving a convertible, but there are some basic tips that can help me narrow down the choices. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's dive into the topic of smart column screening. This episode will be a great choice for separation scientists.
Jen, what are you doing in here? You must be lost.
Hi, Jonathan. Actually, I am lost. I'm trying to figure out what column is best for my analysis.
Ah, you said looking for a column, huh?
Looking for a column.
I got something for you. You ready?
I'm ready.
Behold.
Wow, this is pretty amazing, but still overwhelming. There's a lot of columns here. How do I know which to choose?
Yeah, you're right. There are quite a few in here. But what I can do is I can show you a real simple approach on how to select the right column for your separation. Okay, if we take a look at our base particles, you'll notice to the left we have our hybrid particles, and to the right we have our silica-based particles. Our hybrid particles, our BEH technology and our CSH technology, are excellent when used in alkaline mobile phase. Our silica-based particles, HSS and Cortex, are designed to be used in low pH mobile phase, with HSS having maximum retention and the Cortex having high efficiency and resolution.
Okay, so I see how four different base particles all have unique attributes, but what about the bonded base in these columns?
Great question, Jen. You're exactly right. Not only is it the base particle that leads to your separation, but also the bonded ligand. So let's take a look at four really common bonded ligands that'll help you with your separation.
Great.
Okay, let's take a look at these four bonded phase ligands. We'll start off with a C18, a general purpose ligand that can be used on a wide range of analytes. Next, we'll look at the embedded polar. The embedded polar group offers some hydrophilicity along with the hydrophobicity of that alkyl chain length. Then we'll move into the phenyl group. The phenyl group, due to the pi bond interaction, offers some unique selectivity, especially for aromatic compounds. And then lastly, the pentafluorophenyl group. With the fluorine groups on the outside of the ring and their high electronegativity, offers some unique selectivity, especially when compared to typical C18 bonded phases. So now we put the two together. So first you have a BEH particle with the shield RP18 embedded polar ligand. You then move down to our charged surface hybrid, which has the phenyl ligand. You then move on to a high strength silica particle with a pentafluorophenyl ligand. And lastly, you move on to the Cortex solid core base particle with the alkyl C18 ligand.
Wow, they're just so helpful, thank you. So. Basically, that's a lot more scientific than what I was doing before, which was just choosing the column that I used last time for my analysis.
No problem, Jen. Glad I could help. And as a little going away present, I'm gonna give you this awesome column selectivity chart as a gift. So next time you're lost, you'll find your way.
Score, thank you. Every time I look for a new car, I don't settle on the same year and model that I got the first time. I look for new advances and features that are better. Why didn't I always do that for columns? It's such a shame that I went right back to the same old column each time when there were so many better options out there. Maybe it was because I thought it was hard, but with the new tools I learned about, column screening is not that intimidating, and I could find something really useful that gives me great separation power. Now that is worth the time. So check out the links below to learn more about the detailed method screening assets that were shown in this episode. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.